Hi, James Whiffen for Hey Tuts. Today we're going to be doing an overview of the Primatte keyer. Primatte keyer is a third-party keyer which doesn't come with After Effects, unlike Keylight. However, it has tons and tons of features, and I actually prefer it to Keylight for a few different reasons, some of which I'll hope to share with you today. So let's take a real-world example. We have some green screen footage here, shot on the Alexa. So it's got a bit more color depth, so let's change our project to 32 bits per channel, and let's drag this into a new comp. So we can examine our footage, and we can see that we have to key out hair, body, and some very fine detailed areas of this transparent cloth. So what we're going to want to do is pull a few different keys, just so that we can get the best possible key, because no one combination of settings is going to be great for the skin, the hair, and semi-transparent cloth. And this is just a standard process, splitting up the green screen footage into multiple different parts, whether you're using key light, color keys, or Primatte. This is just the best way to work. So let's name this our hair. And we're going to key the hair in this one. So we want a nice soft key to preserve all this detail in the hair. So let's begin by typing in Primatte and grabbing the Primatte keyer and drag it onto our footage. You'll notice it has a ton of different options. I'm just going to focus on the keying options for the moment, and we'll get to some of the others in a moment. So we do have this auto compute button, which can pull a one click key, but when under extreme time pressures, we want to make sure that we get the best possible key. So we're not going to be using that feature today, but just note that it is there, that it can get you started and get you some pretty good results very quickly, and then you can refine those later. But what we're going to do is pull the best key we can. So let's start by choosing our sampling style. I'm going to choose the point for now, but you can also use the rectangle. And using the point, if we just come down to selection and select background, we can select many different colors, which is great. Normally in Keylight, you can only select one color, but what we can do with Primatte is we can select as many different colors as we want. And once we've selected our initial color, what we can do is view the mat and come in here. And instead of dragging tolerance sliders, we can clean the background by keying additional colors, which is another massive advantage. So we can see we're getting some very weird results in the red, green, and blue channels, but just ignore those. We're working with the mat here. So let's choose to key out some more of these. You'll notice that we're keying with a very low tolerance, and that's the beauty of Primatte, is that we're not taking a shotgun approach and eliminating every shade of green. We're only eliminating the shades that we really need to. We're being very precise, and that's what's going to give us a really nice key. But what we can also do is choose a rectangle and make sure that we select all the different hues, all the different types of green that we definitely need to key there, and you will see that they disappear with almost no change to our hair, because we were being so precise and only selecting the shades of green that we really needed to key, as opposed to shades that might be different types of green. We've left those in there, and that's keeping our key as clean as we can. So if we come back to the RGB, we can turn off Primatte keyer and see what we've done here. Now you'll notice that even though the mat is completely filled in, we're getting some weird results in the color channels. If we turn Primatte keyer off, we can see that the original footage does not have that. So why are we getting some weird results here? And the reason for that is that Primatte is actually despilling this area here, and we might not need it to be despilling that area. So what we can do is come down to refinement, and we can grab the spill minus. And this is basically telling Primatte that you don't need to despill certain areas that we pick. So we're currently sampling from the rectangle. We'll go back to point, and we can say that you don't need to, oops, actually, that's reducing spill. We can say, Primatte, you can actually leave the spill in these areas, and we'll get back to the original result that we had. But now let's continue making this look a little nicer. And what we can do is to improve our hair is using the restore detail tool here. And what this will do is bring detail back into the mat by reducing the opacity. So if we just sample some colors in here that I want to bring back some more detail in. So we're creating a very soft key here by selecting these areas, and we can always go too far, but that's not a problem because we can always either clean the foreground or use the matte sponge to bring that detail back. But it's a bit of to-ing and fro-ing to get a really nice result. So again, I'm just going to select a bit more, and we can see that we're getting these really nice soft fringes here. Again, I've gone a bit too far, so I'll just use the matte sponge to bring that back. And let's check the result here. Got a bit of noise, so we can say that's fine to give this some spill. We're not too concerned. And when we remove or say don't worry too much about this spill suppression, we can choose a replacement color here. So if we add in the background, we can see that that looks pretty good. But what we might want to do is choose a color instead of just neutral gray, a gray that's a bit green, and then we can choose that color there to replace with the background, and we can just lighten it up a little bit. Got to be careful which colors we sample. This makes a big deal to the final result. So that looks pretty good. We have a very nice soft key there. And what you might want to do is also defocus the mat some. And this is a very fine control. So a value of 1 will create a pretty much no difference, or very subtle difference, as opposed to keylight, where adding a pre-blur of 1 is actually quite a drastic change. So I'm going to defocus it maybe 3, and that'll give us a softer result. You can also shrink the mat, but I won't worry about that for now. And what you can also do is under the alpha controls, we basically just have a levels adjustment here if you need it. As I said, Primatte has a lot of tools built in, so it's kind of handy sometimes to have these features if you need them, as opposed to adding a separate effect or a separate levels effect and having the alpha controls there. Something I'd like to talk about now is the spill suppression that we have in Primatte. So if we go to the composite controls and go to spill killer, I'm going to enable the spill killer for green, and we can see that it's done a great job there of killing the green spill. I really like the Primatte's inbuilt spill killing features. Anyone who's done spill suppression before using the hue saturation tool will know that you can get some incredibly grainy results as soon as you remove, say, the green hues for this particular shot. But this is really not bad at all. It does a very good job of getting rid of that spill, but without making it insanely grainy. Obviously, we are getting a bit more grain here than we would otherwise, but it's doing a really good job. So thanks, Spill Killer. Some additional features that we have are the color matcher and light wrap. And you may have seen these before because these are actually bundled in the keying suite or the composite wizard suite. So for example, we can type in light wrap and see that that's in the composite wizard bundle as well as the key correct bundle. But they're also just built into Primatte Keyer, which is nice so that you don't need these extra bundles here. So with the light wrap, what we can do is enable it first and choose a layer. So the background layer would be defined up here, and that would be the forest. And we can see that we're getting our light wrap applied here. I would like to blur the background less and maybe set this to over. I find that gives a more natural looking result here. And we can see the difference that that has made. I think that's done a great job at removing these very harsh colors that, or very harsh strands of hair that we have. And also one thing that is a bit different is just the colors between our background footage and our foreground footage. So what we might do is enable this light wrap here and then just do a little bit of basic color correction. So we have a color matcher here, but I find that it's just easier to add maybe a levels adjustment to do your color correction. So only use the features when you need to. But for now, what I'm just mainly concerned with is that these dark parts of the hair look a lot darker than, say, the black parts of the background footage. So if we wanted to sample more than one pixel, what we could do is just add an adjustment layer and then add a fast blur. So if we wanted to sample, say, the average of 10 pixels, we could add this fast blur here and set it to 10. And if we zoom in here, what this fast blur is doing is basically removing any anomalies such as noise that might skew our results. So we're looking at the info panel and we can see about 0.12 is the average for the red, green and blue channels, and we have slightly more green than red and blue and slightly more red than blue. So what we want to do is mimic that in our foreground footage because they currently don't match. So put the blur in front of the footage here, and what we want to do is increase the output black. So it's very sensitive, so let's go to 0.01 and maybe bump that up, and we're still at around 0.11, whereas the background footage was at about a value of 0.12 in its black. So let's increase this here even a bit more. There we go. And we have more red than green and green than blue in this example, but this is the character's red hair, so that's quite acceptable. But now that our blacks match, any color correction that we apply to all of these will do a much nicer job of matching to now that their blacks are around the same value. So that's looking quite nice. So again, what we'd want to do is isolate the hair because this is our hair key, and we'll just create a garbage mask here. Obviously you would have to animate that if the character was moving. So there's some of the hair, and then we'll just set this mask to none, add in the rest. So that's our very soft key for the hair, and we can set that to add. Now what we need to do is pull another key for our body. So let's duplicate this here, and I'll keep these effects here but reset the Primatte key and just delete the masks. So now pulling a key for the body, what we might want to do is again come back to keying, and we want to select the background. And currently I have the mask tool, so we need to go back to the selection tool, and we want to select some colors here. And again, we have lots of spill that we're getting, so we might want to go into refinement, say we don't need to worry too much about the spill. Even though we are getting spill on this black cloth, it's certainly nowhere near as bad as if the character was wearing white or something similar. And it might be better to just use the rectangle here to remove this aggressive spill reduction. But what we want to do is use the spill reduction in the composite controls. So spill killer, want to enable it for the green. And there we're getting quite a bit more noise. We could turn the strength down just to make it less noisy. We can compromise, but what we want to do is sort of remove this little green fringe here. So I'm going to come to clean background and solo this here, and let's go to the alpha channel, come in here, whoops, and sample some more of these pixels. And what we want to do is get rid of this fringe, so I'm actually going to go to the correction here, grab the restore detail, come in here, and just sample some of those pixels there. And let's see how we're going. So I've eroded the matte a bit too far, but that's fine. We can clean the foreground, and I'll just select point selection method and clean background. Again, a bit of toing and froing, but we're being very precise to pull the best key possible. Okay, so once we have that, what I might want to do is defocus the matte a little bit. And I like to sometimes do a matte choker just to get the edges looking really nice. So I'm going to use the matte choker here. Obviously the default settings are quite extreme. I want to increase the gray level softness to maybe 15%, the choke to maybe a very small amount, and the geometric softness to 4. Now this is still looking rather sharp. What we can do is just view it at full resolution, and then we can see we're getting a very nice key for the rest of the body here. So what we might want to do now is copy these masks here, paste them, but we want the opposite. So as you can see, the key that worked really great for the skin and the body definitely didn't work well for the hair, so that's why we're keying in separate parts, and this one you would want to subtract on both. And what we can do is actually expand the mask. Negative one pixel is what we want. -1 and -1. And then we can turn on the hair. And then background. And there we have our separate keys being pulled. So I hope you've enjoyed this overview of Primatte here, and I would definitely recommend using it. It's got some great features and what I believe to be a more intelligent method of sampling pixels, as opposed to Keylight, where you only get to sample one color and then you just drag the sliders. With Primatte here, you get to choose the exact colors that you want in a very refined way. So that's why I like Primatte here, and thank you for watching this tutorial.